Sometimes we forget to see the beauty around us, or the people around us, or we stop pausing to get impressions and make room for inspiration in our lives. And we get kind of caught up with the unimportant and sometimes miss things that are really beautiful and special. Not saying that I was really beautiful and special, but it was an analogy. But I wanted to do this as my Christmas music video because I wanted it to be a metaphor in a way for the fact that when Jesus Christ came to this earth, you know, he was standing right in front of people doing miracles. He was, you know, the Son of God, and yet he was barely recognized by anyone for who he was because people had their blinders on. And, you know, it was really an interesting experience when I was down there, and I didn't expect that it would make me feel the way I felt because, you know, here I had just gotten off a sold-out tour, you know, where people had come to see me. We were all over Europe, and here I was just being ignored by everyone. And it emotionally kind of made me remember how it felt when I first started my career. If you could even call it a career at that time, I mean, I was playing anywhere that I could, just hoping that people would listen to my music. You know, everything from open mic nights to I would play on college campuses. I'd always try to get the 1:30 slot when the Taco Bell line was super long. But they had no choice but to watch me jump around and play. But I remember just craving, hoping that someone would actually hear my music and see the beauty in it and feel like I had something to offer. But I remember feeling so ignored and unseen. And then if I go back even farther, when I first started college, I was suffering from anorexia. And I was struggling pretty bad with depression as a result of it. And I had kind of just dug myself into this hole. And it wasn't only, you know, not only did I think no one saw the beauty in my art, but I felt like no one saw the beauty in me because I couldn't see it at all. And I remember looking in the mirror during this time and just hating everything I saw looking back at me. I honestly hated myself. And finally, I realized that I had a problem and that I needed to change. I needed to figure a way out to pull myself from this hole. And so I did everything from individual counseling to group therapy to reading books to positive thinking exercises. I basically turned working on my happiness into a full-time job. And slowly I started to change. And I started to remember the person I used to be and find happiness again. And the thing that kind of was the catalyst that started the change and made it possible for me to change was that I realized I've believed my whole life that I'm a daughter of God. And my whole life I've believed that Jesus Christ suffered and died for me. And if someone paid a price for me, and if someone suffered for me, then I must have worth. And that made sense to me. And that's what started the change. And I share this with you because no matter how you feel about yourself right now, whether it's that you have a dream that you wish people would see and you wish you could accomplish and you want it more than anything, or whether you look in the mirror and you wish you could like what you see, or maybe you just wish you could be happy. I know what all of those feelings feel like. And I'm here to tell you that I'm a very different person today, extremely different person than I was several years ago. And it came from a lot of hard work, faith, and also it came from first. All of these things happened, everything in this room, because I learned to see the beauty in myself. And if you can't see the beauty in yourself yet, I know it's possible, and trust that somebody can. Someone will always be able to see the beauty in you. And so as we play this song for you guys, I want you to ponder that. I want you to think about it. Look inward and think about the things that make you beautiful.